Any bit of research is going to involve a lot of searching through literature. Particularly when you come to the stage of doing a literature review, there's going to be a lot of delving through bibliographic databases in order to find what research exists out there already. I've been doing a lot of this lately as I've gone back to do a bit more literature review work, and I've been searching through again to see whether there is any new research that's popped up. But also I think it's healthy every so often to go back and do another search through the literature, because some articles or papers or books which might not have seemed relevant 2 months ago, since I've been doing more reading, might suddenly become absolutely vital for my project. So today I wanted to take a look at some methods for using online databases to do some really good literature searching. Now there's many really good bibliographic databases out there. The one I use for my initial searches is Google Scholar. Now all of the various search engines tend to be imperfect in some way. There's some things they'll throw up that others won't, and there's some things that they'll miss out. Google Scholar reaches into a few different bibliographic databases, which is really, really useful because it gives a really good overview. And also it's got some extra little functions which I'll talk about a little bit later on. So the first thing that you can always do on Google Scholar is just use it like Google usually. So at the moment I've been doing a lot of research on city differentiation, so looking at what makes a city a global city or a metropolitan city or a cosmopolitan city, as opposed to a regional city or a non-cosmopolitan city, etc, etc, etc. So if I want to look up global cities, I can very simply just type in global cities. But the terminology in this field for global cities can often vary. So sometimes they're called global cities, but sometimes they're equally also called cosmopolitan cities. Sometimes they're also called metropolitan cities. So what I can start to do is I can put in some Boolean operators, so that's our kind of ands or ors, and I can put in global cities or cosmopolitan cities or metropolitan cities. You can also use ands. Usually what Google Scholar do will it be to assume an and if there's not a Boolean there. But it does mean I could simplify this search by doing global or cosmopolitan or metropolitan cities. I could also equally do and cities or city. I could also then do and regional or non-metropolitan or non-cosmopolitan, and that's going to suddenly bring my search results down and really refine to some kind of differentiation articles. There are a number of other kind of Boolean operators you can use which really help to refine a search, particularly if you're in the sciences and have to do a kind of systematic review where you have to make sure you find everything on a particular topic. They can be particularly useful. But there's a couple of other tools on Google Scholar which I find incredibly useful. So recently I've been doing a lot of research around regional cities and globalization. But what I'll quite often find is that lots of these articles will be quite old. So there's one here from 1999, 2000, and actually this is a field which moves very, very quickly. So Google Scholar gives us the ability to refine our search by date. So if I want something really, really, really recent, I can click since 2017, and I'll suddenly get articles which have only been published this year. Now, one of the great things about doing literature searches is that often literature will lead to literature. If you've watched my other video where I talk about taking notes on literature, you'll know that I keep a to-read list as I'm reading any singular bit of literature, which essentially allows me to follow the trail back to work that's referenced in a piece that I'm reading. The downside of that is that trail only leads backwards. So it leads us from a piece that's written in 2017, say, to a piece that's written in 2010, and then a piece that's referenced in the 2010 piece might then go back even further. So a particularly useful tool in Google Scholar, and one that I only discovered particularly recently, is that underneath each result there is a cited by button, which essentially allows you to see any work that has cited that particular article. So say I read this article, Globalization as Reterritorialization, and found it really, really useful, but when I want to find work that is like that, but is more recent, suddenly I can click Cited By, and it will take me to all of the articles that have cited that article or book since. Now, sometimes a citation might be quite loose, and so an article citing another article might actually be quite off topic. So another great function is the fact that Google Scholar allows us to search within those. So if I really liked this article here, I could then search for regional cities within the articles that had cited that previous article. And this is a really, really useful way of building really comprehensive literature lists for different topics. I've recently done it with both theatre and cities and theatre and globalisation, and it's really helped me to have a really complete list of everything that exists on those topics so that I can have that to refer back to and use within my literature review to make sure there's really not any holes in what I'm doing. Finally, sometimes the links through from Google Scholar are a little bit off, or sometimes they won't work, so quite often I'll find that I have to go over to my university search engine and then search for a particular article within the library article search there. But actually, what Google Scholar is really, really useful for is it's really great at finding work, and then you might find that you have to actually go and find it to read somewhere else. So I tend to use Google Scholar more as a bibliographic finding tool rather than for finding the links to the articles themselves. And the great thing then is that you can find the article and then bring it into Mendeley or Zotero or whatever the citation software is that you use. So that's a few tips on doing a literature search for a thesis or dissertation or essay that you're working on. Do let me know if your system is slightly different, if you've got any tips. There are, as I say, some other kind of Boolean operators you can use. There are other bibliographic databases available, which you may find better. And particularly for different subjects, there will be bibliographic databases that are better for particular fields. If you've enjoyed this, then please do give it a thumbs up or subscribe, and I will be back on Tuesday with another video. Thank you very much.